they were going to release that without Billie Jean on it. And Quincy said, "Billie Jean, you know, I ain't got no time for that." And Michael went up to Larkin, this big cat over at CBS, you know, who was head of A&R, and Michael, you know, pitched a bitch. His idea of pitching a bitch was he started crying, you know. He said, "No, please, you got to, you know. Michael performed so much that Larkin's finally said, "Okay, we'll hold the production. You get it together." And that, Billie Jean, you're the one. Yeah, it was the one.
Not only was Billie Jean on the album, in 1983, it was chosen to launch the whole Thriller campaign.
I really got a brief from Michael saying it would be nice to do some dancing in the video and to save a little chorus for him to dance to. And the management said that he'd been practicing in front of the mirror, which is like, we thought was quite amusing. Cameras handheld in front of him along that sidewalk, because I was operating the camera myself. Then he started dancing, and I hadn't, well, none of us had seen anything of him dancing. The world hadn't really seen this new Michael, you know, what he'd worked on for this album. The adrenaline that caused in me, my body temperature just rose and really made the camera steam up.
In fact, Michael Jackson had been looking to the streets of LA to inspire his new campaign.
I worked with Michael and showed him the moonwalk. We went to Michael's dance sanctuary. He was still living in the Jackson family house in Encino. Over the garage, he has a place called the gallery, and that's where he does his dancing. Even if no one's there, he just goes there alone. There's a series of dances that I would show him. Of course, the robot is a mechanical, you know, robot. The main thing is lock, 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 lock. We have our set choreography that we're going to do. So like, he's got the choreography, he's into that, he's got that down. Now he's putting Michael Jackson into the choreography. He's grabbing the back of his head and pop, you know, and back into the thing. Or he breaks out of it to go, "Oh!" And back into the choreography. I mean, he's just in and out of this thing like this. And it's just like, this guy is owning this stuff, you know?
MTV said, no, it's not our demographic. And then the door was closed for a couple of weeks. I mean, they were definitely trying for MTV, but I think the reason primarily was because he was black. And they felt that their audience, the audience they were aiming for was the Midwest. And pop songs, pop and black, didn't quite go together in their eyes at that time.
But Michael Jackson was about to take his destiny into his own hands.
Motown 25.
He agreed to appear on Motown's 25th anniversary celebration, but on one condition: that they let him showcase Billie Jean before its primetime TV audience.
You know, those were good songs. I like those songs a lot, but especially I like the new songs.
Down to the pinky. In theater, we talk about intensity, right? We talk about being aware of your energy and know that you can stand on stage and the energy in your ear can shoot to the back of the house. Every inch, every part, every nature of the body is like, has that. From the feet to the hand, always doing something. Energy.
She told me
was just Michael. Again, the wardrobe. It's not performance wardrobe. He just wore that.
The outfit he wore was something that he asked my mother, could he wear it for my closet? And that was the black thing you saw him, because he liked it, because it shined and it moved.
Listen, he's just boogieing, you know? Look at this. He's just boogieing. Michael Jackson is just a boogie man. He's boogieing. Like, you can't say it's jazz, or it's modern, or it's tap dance. Look at him. He's expressing himself. That's just expression.
From what I could see, from backstage through the curtains, among the heads that were peering out around me, Michael was a sensation. And he did some things that James had never done, that Fred Astaire had never done. We all learned a lesson that day, that you could come up with new stuff and do your own thing.
This is Michael Jackson. You're not gonna get away with saying that is anyone else's creation. Like, Michael Jackson created that. That's a Michael Jackson move.
I was on the side of curtains with all the rest of the artists from the Temptations, Swing Rounds and Miracles, and they were looking at him as if he was a star, and they were just starting.
This is Michael Jackson, so look at the audience, rocking to it. All types of colors, different people from around the world can enjoy this. It's not just for one culture. This is world. Those little riffs, those things, like James Brown and like people of that nature. Okay, then he does the moonwalk. Now there are people in China who never saw the moonwalk before. That's why that moment is so big. But to the people who live or who know what that is, we home like, oh yeah, man, he bigged us up. Like, he said, yeah, man, this is for y'all. You know, so that's how I feel when he does that. Things like that, he's just paying tribute.
I've never seen him do it until then. All the performances we did on tours way before that, I've never seen him do it until that night.
I'm surprised because we started showing Michael the backside in 1980. He wouldn't do it publicly until 83. He was waiting for the opportune time to do this. And I think that was his first opportune time.
Day after Motown 25, by the end of the school day, you saw nothing but black scuff marks on the end of the floor from like all different directions.
It's such an incredible performance, and it did so much for him. It boosted his entire career. That one moment in time boosted his entire career. It was a great moment.
From that point on, his albums started selling like 300-some thousand copies a week or more. Yeah, and that's why Thriller. That's what really sorted through the roof. Thriller is like the greatest selling album of all times.